like, take all my mind, take all the joy now. Take me down, take all the love now. Tie me away, burn me alive now. Break me down right now. Now you wanna lock me away, I'm winning. You wanna add to my pain, I'm shining. Now you won't come for my face. Ideally, we're not the same, no, no. So why you wanna try me? Yeah, try me, you're out to destroy.
Favorite Navy boy here. So in today's video, I'll be giving you guys a breakdown of my experience all through my Navy school and my experience so far on board, because I've been having like series of questions as to how the entire experience was like and everything, like just step by step. So yeah, in today's video I'll be giving you guys all the tea. So before further ado, if this is the first time you're seeing me on your screen, just do well to subscribe. If you're already subscribed to my channel, please give this video a thumbs up. So with that being said,
let's get straight into the video.
Welcome back, guys. So like I said earlier, today's video is going to be like a more like a life updates video. So let me start from the beginning of the beginning. So when I was in secondary school, I had always wanted to be like an architect because I had a thing for like drawing and all. But I felt like, yeah, that could be like my calling because I was actually good at it to an extent. So I'd already made up my mind that that's what I was going to do. So when I got to SS3, my uncle now told me, like, because he's a captain as well, so he now brought up the idea that what if I decided to work on a ship. So I don't know, when he said that, it felt like it felt like weird, like, are you sure I would be able to do that? But then in another way, it felt like something I would want to experience, because it's something that is not everywhere and something that I would love to be a part of. So I agreed to it and we started making plans towards me going to the school I ended up going to. So when I was done with my work, my dad was now suggesting that I go and start working first. But then I wasn't ready to start working first, so I told him, okay, let's do it like this. Either let me try going to school, and then if I do not get admission, then I could just opt for the option of working first. So once I told him that, he was now like, okay, fine, let's just not just put all our baskets in, I mean, all our eggs in one basket. I mean, how did he say it? Okay, so with that being said, I went to Maritime Academy of Nigeria for like the screening exercise, because when you want to get into this school, you need to like apply, because when it was my set, it was more like a physical form of screening. So we had to go down to the school. So when I got to the school, we had like series of examinations, but the physical, the written, the oral exams, and we had like physical fitness examination as well, and yeah, normal your medicals. So we did all of that. It was a success, but we're like very much, and I was kind of like skeptical about if I was going to get in, because I saw people that had come there for like 3 years, 4 years, and they still have not gotten admission. So I was like kind of scared, but to God be the glory, I was able to get my admission and I got into school. I resumed school like in January, but we came for a screen in December 2018, but I officially resumed like January 1st 2019. So I started school by 2019. So the name of my school is Maritime Academy of Nigeria. It's located in Akwa Ibom. So it's more like a polytechnic here. So based on the fact that it's a maritime school, so the courses are strictly related to just maritime courses. Because some people ask me questions like, if I study computer science or if I study a non-related course, you would not be able to gain admission into the school. So the courses that are being offered in my school are nautical science, marine engineering, that's electrical electronics engineering, and MTBS. So these courses are strictly related to maritime, so that's why they are being offered in my school. Well, that's that for that. So in order to seek admission to Maritime Academy of Nigeria, you would need to I'm just saying this based off how my own admission process was like. So it was mandatory, you make the school your first choice for JAMB. Like when you once you register for JAMB, if the school is not your first choice, just forget it. The likelihood of you getting admission is quite slim. So you need to make the school your first choice, and yeah, just be very hopeful. Basically, my school was like a high level of secondary school because we're literally wearing uniform, we're like jogging, there was like match pass, you know, as paramilitary, so but we're like paramilitary school, so we're not necessarily like military, so the whole drilling and regimentation is not like as intense as it would be in like ND and all of that. So but we had like basic drills and training that we had to undergo. Drills were basically carried out based on the fact that we are being trained to be officers. So based off that fact, it was expected of us to be like to be able to comport ourselves and like present ourselves in a certain way, so which explains the whole regimentation. Our first semester started off, but at some point we had to go back home because of COVID. We now started having online classes and all. So the online classes wasn't really to our advantage because there were certain things that would have learned practically, but based on the fact that it was an online kind of class session, it was kind of difficult to really catch up. So once the whole online stuff was over, we now went back to school rather. So once we got back to school, it was us, just everybody just trying to, you know, get back on track and just really get into it. So once we finally got back to school, we had to write exams because it was like 2 weeks to exam, and everybody was like everywhere, everywhere you were going, people were literally reading. So we had to just skip through with that, and most of us, our GPA had to drop. We actually dropped based off the fact that we're not 100% prepared and we're just trying to, you know, patch everything all together. So finally, eventually, we scaled through the first semester and we finally graduated to our second semester. So my school is like a polytechnic here. So we have like ND and HND. You can decide to start working after your ND, but it's better you equally have your HND certificate because at some point it will be useful if you want to further in this line of profession. So we moved down to our second semester and we were all in school all through that period. So our second semester, you know, we're in like a Navy school, so we're to like wear uniforms. We had like series of training and drills, both physically and, you know, mentally. Though it was going to be better if you could adjust to both the drilling as well as your academics, because you do not want anyone to suffer, especially your academics, because why did you come to school? The academics wasn't really hard, because if you read, you'd pass like any other school. But based off the pressure from the whole regimentation, some people would have like could consider having issues with trying to balance everything, but I was able to at least balance. And based on the group I joined, like for the regimentation aspects, it's kind of like reduced the workload for me in that area, so I was able to focus more on academics. So all through school period, you know, theoretical aspects of everything we're going to be learning while we go on board or when we go on board, that was what was being carried out. So everybody had to just stay on track and understand what they could understand as much as they could before getting a placement to go on board. So before we had to be doing our series, the COVID time, we were meant to go on board initially for a CWES, that I think is Student Industrial Work experience scheme, something like that. So we're meant to go on board for that, but we didn't go on board again because of COVID. So we had like little or no experience of what was going on board. So we just had to keep up with the whole theoretical aspect and merge everything with the whole regimentation. So once we're done, we finally finished the entire regimentation and all of that, and then finally we're able to scale through. So I think I forgot to mention, once you go to my school, you'd have to pass your first semester, and once you pass your first semester, you'd be given a laptop, and yeah, you'd scale through to the next semester. But if you fail the first semester, you'd be going home, pack your load and go home. But then that's just for that. So once we're done, we finally finished and I graduated. I think that was 2021. I graduated from school 2021. So now over to the next phase. Once I was done with school, I now had to move over to the next phase, which was getting a placement that was going to practically do everything I have been taught while I was in school. So finding a placement was going to be an issue for like certain person. Well, a disclaimer, this is a disclaimer. Some people have like this ideology that once you're done from my school, it's very easy to get a job, or it's like very easy to like find placements or stuff. But it's not as easy as you think. But now I think it's better off than how it used to be. But regardless, it's not just as easy as you might think it is. So by God's grace and the help of my uncle, I was able to get a placement, and I was given a date to resume when I'd be going on board. I think I resumed around March. Yeah, I resumed around March. So here's the thing. There are different kind of vessels with different ship designs, and for the fact that they have different ship designs means they have different operation vessels, like platform support vessels, tanker vessels, diver support vessels, multi-purpose vessels, fast FSIVs, anchor handling. They're just different vessels for different operations at sea. So the vessel that I was opportune to work on was a platform support vessel. So a PSV vessel, our major operation was basically transferring both liquid and the cargo from like the ports, which is at the shore, to the high sea. So we were working for Total, so we had to move cargo from the ports down to the sea. So when I went on board by March 2022, as I went on board, yeah, 2022. Before going on board, I don't know, I get questions like, can you swim? Can you swim? Like almost every time, and I actually cannot swim. And the funniest part is like a couple of my mates as well, we equally can't swim. But then the question is it actually mandatory for you to be able to swim before going on board? The answer is literally no, because NIMASA, which is like the body that is like governing the whole maritime sector, they did not necessarily make it mandatory that you know how to swim. It's basically necessary that you know how to survive in a case that you'd have to go overboard, or like there's a fire outbreak or something, so you would know what to do in such scenarios. Like I said earlier, before going on board, you need certain certifications like your medicals, your SCCW, your discharge book, your international passports, and all of that basically. But like, you would need to have other certifications aside from your school certification. So I had to get my school certification because I was coming to be an officer. On board, there are different positions for different crew members. There are some people that do not necessarily have like the whole standard school system, but they just had to undergo these courses that would enable them work on board. So with that being said, there are various roles of officers, as well as there are different roles of ratings. So the ratings are like the able seaman, the ordinary seaman, the cook, there's like a cook, the steward, and the likes of that. Whereas so, I wouldn't like the fact that you get the first class does not mean you would understand everything on board. put that in your ear. So the fact that I was feeling like, oh yeah, it's cannot be as hard as anything. I went on board, like the first 3 days, I felt like I did not know anything. I felt like my 2 years in school, is it for waste? Because the entire 2 years I'd been in school, everything was all theoretical. So when I went back on board, you know, you're not seeing these devices that you were being taught about, how to use it and all of that. But then, you know, it's a little bit different when you have a theoretical understanding and when you now have to actually practicalize what you've been taught. So when I went on board, you know, questions were flying here and there as far went to in the school I went to, as well as the fact that I came out with first class. So questions were flying here and there. The captain, the chief officer, second officer, all of them were just giving me questions here and there. I was like, Omo, you should calm down. So they asked for the first 3 days, Omo, I couldn't answer like 80% of the questions. I could not answer anything. It was giving. Did you waste your 2 years in school? But regardless, I was able to scale through after like 1 month of adapting with like the whole system and going back to my book and all of that. I was able to adapt and get the whole scope. Alright, so for the sake of the fact that I had already understood certain things, so I was, you know, it's a gradual process. Before I forget, there is like stages before you can finally get to a captain. So in between these stages, you would have to undergo certain durations to enable you move on to the next stage. So the first stage I am at now is the IT stage, being a cadet. So while I'm a cadet, I'll have to have like at least 18 or like at least 12 months experience on a ship that's like fully operational. And I have like a logbook to give like an account of, okay, my sea time, and I was actually on board for this duration of time. So once I'm joined as a cadet, I will now move over to being a second officer. So being a second officer, I would still have to have like at least like 18 months experience as a second officer before going back to school and writing another exams to enable me become a chief officer. Then once I become a chief officer, still same sequence, I'll have to go back to school, write exams to enable me to become captain. And yeah, when you become a captain, that's like the max. But you can still push ahead and like get like more other certifications to get you more opportunities. So with that being said, I am still a cadet, yeah, and I am yet to complete my entire my entire CTEP. I've done like 10 months so far, meaning like 2 months to complete the entire 1 year. So while the time I was on board, I was just being shown how to, you know, move the vessel and, you know, do certain things. The role of an officer, an OOW on a ship, is basically navigating of a vessel from a position to the other safely, like safely navigating a vessel, as well as the safety. So the safety of the crew as well as the ship and the environment is in the hands of the officers. Well, I think basically all the crew on board, but majorly on the officers. Through the time I was on board, I was being shown how to like carry out drills and how drills are conducted, how filing system works, and the basic firefighting equipment on board, different things to do in different scenarios and different emergencies and all of that. So I was able to understand all of that, but I wasn't allowed to do certain things because, you know, there are limits to things you can do based off the fact that I was not certified to do everything. But I had the chance to understand how to do certain things. I don't know if that makes sense. So I had the chance to understand it, but I wasn't allowed to do it. So after I think 5 months on board, yeah, after 5 months on board, I was finally given the chance to move the vessel for the first time. So we are at sea, and then my captain just told me that I should just move the ship. Though we are at the open sea, so we're not close to an installation or any other ship, so there wasn't going to be any cause for a collision. So he gave me the opportunity to move the ship manually. So the ship has various propulsion system. My vessel has like a diesel electric propulsion system, that's like an azimuth propulsion system rather, but a diesel electric generating system. So the propulsion system was kind of complicated, because if you want the vessel to go like to the right, you'd have to turn the steer to like the left. So it was like a little bit complicated, but I understood the concept rather. So I was able to move the vessel, but you know, as far as it was the first time, the current, the waves and all of that, they were like making the whole thing like a little bit hard, but I was able to, but with constant, they were constantly giving me like chances, and I was able to finally, I wouldn't really say I'm perfect now, but I'm like better than how I started off. Well, aside from that, I was equally given an opportunity to set the vessel on DP. So for those of you that did not understand what DP is like a dynamic positioning system, which is used to ensure the vessel is being fixed in a particular position. So like irrespective of the environmental factors that might lead to the vessel moving to a certain direction, such as the wind, current, the wave, and all of that. The DP system is set in, is programmed to use the active thrusters to keep the vessel in the particular position. So in order to have like a feedback to that position you are trying to set, there's like an antenna at the monkey island of the vessel, that's like the highest point in the ship, which sends a signal to either a reference system or the satellite. So once it's a reference system is being sent, it's being sent to that as a reference. So when it's being sent, it just gives back like that, okay, this is where I want to be, this is where you should make me be, this is where I want to be for like this certain period of time, so I don't want to shift from here. So that's like what is going on. So when it sends that reference system, the vessel will be fixed in that particular position. But now getting a certification to be a DP officer is very expensive, and like the officers are like certified to operate on a DP vessel. So my captain, I think one time like that, he gave me the opportunity to set up on DP, so I had to understood how the whole concept worked a little bit better. And then over time, I was given the opportunity to equally go alongside using the DP. It was kind of, I was feeling like, you know, when you're like afraid of, I don't want to go fail, I don't want to go and hit something, you know, like I was like, I need to be afraid. But thank God for my captain, I was able to understand the concept and, you know, scale through as I should. I feel like that's like basically everything. But before I finally finish the video, I'll just answer a few questions that I've been getting as regards my entire profession. Do you get paid as an intern? Okay, so the question was, do I get paid as an intern? The answer is yes, I get paid as an intern, but the salary I get, or the salary anybody gets in my field as an intern, is in respect to the company. So the company decides how much it decides to pay the cadets. So I'm being paid, but like my salary is not that much, but at least it's better than nothing. So I get paid as an intern, but it's dependent on your company. Some company might decide actually to not pay you, and some might decide to pay you. So it's not really mandatory, but yeah, I do get paid. How long do you stay on board? Okay, so the next question is how long, oh my God, is it fly? All right, so in real sense, you know, I am just interning, so I'm not practically working on board. So I stayed on board for a longer duration of time, but in real sense, I would not have stayed for that long. So when I start working professionally, I would not be staying for that long. I would be staying for like 2 months. Well, it's dependent on like the contract and the company's preference. But if I would still be working where I work now, it would be easy to... I'd be staying for like 2 months on, 2 months off. Okay, last question before I round up this. Okay, last question is, does being an intern in a company guarantee you getting a job there? The answer is no. Yeah, this is why I said no. Okay, so if you're working as an intern in a company, They are just giving you an opportunity to have an experience of what working on board feels like. Would it give you an upper edge if you want to come back to work there? It would definitely give you like this, you know, you form like this form of like familiarity with like the people you're working with, as well as the company-based crew. So everybody is already like kind of familiar with you. So if you come and like to apply for a job, it's easier for them to consider you, but it doesn't guarantee that they would actually give you the job. But it's just like, oh, I'm familiar with this person and I know to an extent what he can do and what he cannot do. So it becomes easier for you to actually get a job there. But other than that, it's not really a guarantee. You'd have to be actually screened and certified by the crewing manager to ensure that you are the right person for the job. So yeah, well I think this is all I can say for now. So at the point now, I am basically yet to complete my intern, and once I'm done, I'm going back to school next year to write my external exams that will enable me to start working. So I'll need to write my OOW exams, officer of the watch exams. So once I write that exams, I'll be able to now go back to work as a second officer. So well guys, I think with this video I've been able to explain to an extent how this whole process works and all of that, right? But thank you guys for staying this long. I really do appreciate. Just do well. If you've not subscribed yet to my YouTube channel, I really don't know what you're waiting for. Just do well to subscribe, share, like, comment down below. Because like, comment down below. What's me doing? Contents, Instagram, YouTuber thing. Yeah, just comments. I don't know, here or here, but just do it. Comment down below, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, share the word. Tell people that would want to work as an officer in Marina, a seafarer, or anything like that, to just watch this video, have a better insight. And thank you guys for your time.